In today's video, we're going to talk about automation testing with Cypress. In the previous videos, we talked about using Selenium, but today we're going to talk about using Cypress instead. So Cypress is a modern end-to-end testing framework primarily designed for web applications. It enables developers and QA professionals to write, execute, and maintain tests for the web applications, ensuring that the user interface and functionality behave as expected. Cypress is known for its simplicity, fast execution, and developer-friendly features. So here are some of the key features for Cypress. The first is end-to-end testing. Cypress focuses on end-to-end testing, ensuring that an application works as intended from a user's perspective, interacting with every component from the UI to the backend services. The second feature is real browser execution. Unlike other testing frameworks that simulate browser behavior, Cypress runs tests in real browsers, providing an accurate representation of how users interact with a web application. The third key feature is automatic waiting. Cypress automatically waits for commands and assertions to complete, meaning you don't have to manually write wait commands for elements to load. And the final key feature of Cypress is time travel. Cypress takes screenshots as your tests run. You can step back in time to see what happened at each step, making debugging easier. So some of the benefits of using Cypress. The first is developer-centric. Cypress provides great debugging tools and is designed to be highly integrated with developer workflows, enabling developers to write tests as they code. Cypress also has fast feedback loop. The Cypress Test Runner allows developers to see the test results instantly as they write or modify tests, ensuring faster feedback. Cypress also contains modern JavaScript framework support. Cypress works well with modern JavaScript frameworks like React, Angular, and Vue, supporting their specific patterns and component lifestyle cycles. Cypress does not require additional setup for WebDriver or browser drivers. Simply install Cypress via NPM, and it's ready to use. With built-in retry mechanisms and automatic waits, Cypress tests are more reliable and less flaky compared to other end-to-end testing tools. And finally, Cypress comes with extensive and well-organized documentation that guides users through installation, writing tests, and advanced usage. So we mentioned that previously we looked mostly at Selenium, and today we're looking at Cypress. So I'm just going to do a quick comparison between Selenium and Cypress. So for the execution environment, Cypress runs directly in the browser and the same run loop as the application under test, while Selenium controls the browsers externally. For language support, Cypress only supports JavaScript, so that's the downside. But Selenium supports multiple languages like Java, Python, C#, and so on. Cypress is more developer-friendly with a built-in interactive test runner, whereas Selenium follows a more traditional approach with drivers and web driver APIs. Now, here are the typical use cases for Cypress. For example, UI testing. You want to validate that user interfaces behave as expected under various conditions. There's also end-to-end testing, so you want to simulate real user interactions from navigating the web app to interacting with UI components. And then there's also API testing, so you want to test backend services by intercepting requests and validating responses using Cypress Intersect. And then there's also integration testing, where you want to test how different components of an application integrate with each other. Cypress is a powerful tool that simplifies end-to-end testing for modern web applications, helping ensure the applications work seamlessly from the user's perspective. So here's a brief introduction of how you can install Cypress. So for this project that we're going to show you today, first you're going to have to install Visual Studio Code, and then you're going to have to create a folder within VS Code, and then in the terminal, you'll have to install Cypress through NPM. And these are the three commands that you use. Okay, so now I'm going to walk you through how to set up your own project, and then maybe we can see some examples as well. So the first thing you want to do is you want to click Open Folder, and then I'm going to store this under Cypress right here, and I'm going to call it Create a New Folder for this video, so Video 1. And then I'm going to select this folder, and then now I have this folder. So now to install Cypress in your new folder package, what you can do is you can install it directly in terminal. So you can go to open up your terminal by going to the terminal, new terminal. And then the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to type npm install Cypress, and then dash dash save dev. Okay, so go ahead and enter that. And then it'll take some time for you to install it. But since I already have NPM installed, Cypress installed earlier, this was really quick for me. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do NPM audit fix dash dash force to see if there's any issues. And so there's no problems, so everything is good. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do npm init. And this will be good for a configuration later on. So I'm going to name this package video. Version 1 is good. Description will be Cypress tutorials. And then this is good. No test command, no git repository, no keywords. Author will be ADM Lucid. No license. And there you go. So now that we have this package, the next thing we can do now is we can do npx cypress open. And what this will do is this will open another browser. And I'm just going to drag it over. So this is what it opened on my other window. And we have two things here now. We have E2E testing with component testing. Today I want to show you E2E testing. So end-to-end testing. So I'm going to click this. And now you have all these different things. So configuration files, we added the following files to your project. So they added some configuration files for Cypress. They also added Cypress support E2E test JavaScript files, command files, and so on. So you just click continue, and then they'll add that to your folder. So I'm going to do this in Chrome, but there's some other options as well. For example, Edge, Electron, which is the one that they ship, and then Firefox. So I'm just going to do Chrome. So start E2E testing in Chrome. And then what I'm going to do is, since this project is new, they're going to give you two options. You should start creating your own specs, your own tests, or you can use your template test. So what I'm going to do for the sake of this demo is I'm going to show you some of the features of Cypress. So go ahead and click scaffold example test. Okay, I got it. And now is the example test that they give you. So before I go into there, I want to show you what the folder now looks like. So if I go back to here, we see that there's a Cypress folder now. And they created all these different subfolders and this config file as well. So I'm going to go ahead and run this to do for you. So while you're running Cypress, what it'll actually do is it'll run it in the browser and then it'll have this on the side. So it's really intuitive web interface for you to use. And you can see that it'll run here. So this is Chrome. It'll run here in Chrome. And then right here, it'll show you the history of everything you did. So for example, this one is for to-do list. And I can look at this example. So I can open up the example and I can see what it's doing. So this is displays two to-do list items by default. So if I click that, it'll show you what it did. So, and if I hover each of these, it'll show you that this is what it is. And then it'll show you what how it goes through different steps. I can also click this one to show you other stuff as well, and so on and so on. So this is one of the basic examples. I'm gonna show you a little bit more advanced examples. So using actions right here. So go ahead and run this by clicking it. And this one will basically test various different actions. For example, typing, blurring, clearing, submitting, clicking, checking, selecting, scrolling, triggering, scroll to as well. And this one uses this thing right here, which gives you all these different options. And so if you scroll through this, this tutorial is really nice and really interesting for you to look through. For example, if I click the typing one, I can go here and we can see that it'll type stuff into the web page on the side to my right here. But yeah, so this is Cypress. Cypress is really intuitive. It uses this browser right here. And for this video right now, I just did this so that you would understand how to use Cypress and how to set up your project. In the next videos that we'll make, we'll go through more in-depth tutorials on how to make your own Cypress test for the future. If you enjoyed this video, please give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening, and we look forward to seeing you next time.